evil priest can prevent us from feeling that we are the children of Hitler. Away with incense and holy water. The swastika brings salvation on earth. Thank you.
Thank you. And I, the complacent American, thinking that no one would ever dare attack an American city.
And I told my friends that nuclear war, this would never happen. I always thought I was a good one.
Thank you. pools of dust that blow along the street are not moving. The swirl of dust moves wherever the wind takes it. The gust of wind stops, and the dust settles. Now, multiply this whirlpool of dust to cover the Trans-Mississippi Great Plain, and you have a tragedy of nature called a dust storm. The wind-swept area is called the Dust Bowl. November 1933, the dust storm began. The question on the lips of all the farmers was, when is it going to rain? But the rain did not come. The nightmare dragged on. Hot winds fanned the dry ground and particles of dust were put into the air. Day after day, the drought and the hot winds continued. The air was so filled with dust that the sun was cool. What was happening?
The Great Plains had experienced drought and hot winds for months. The farmers in that area had foolishly cultivated more than a third of the land to grow wheat. The tough, wiry Perry girl.
The world needed more wheat, and more ground was ripped up by the sharp steel blade of the plow. The fertile topsoil dried out, and the
winds carried the particles of earth
high into the air. Fields, fences, house, and livestock were buried under the wind. People set out torches with dust masks on their faces. They watched the dirty brown wind blow and blow. Cattle died by the thousands, suffocated by dust. Damp and dust. More wind.
More dust.
Thank you. simple operation, and all the decisions are made by the machine.